Hi everyone, George here from Locked On Art. In this video, I will be building the M4A3 Sherman with the T-34 rocket launcher system, or Calliope as it was nicknamed, due to its similar appearance of that of a pipe organ. This kit is from Academy and was released in 2015, although most of the sprue are dated as far back as 1999. The only new addition seems to be the T-34 rockets, which I will be almost entirely scratch building, as the tubes have been split in half and a lot of the details have been missed and also wrong. Okay, so we'll just have a quick look at what you get in the box. There's not a huge amount in there, though there's some nice detailing on a 50 cal machine gun. Standard Sherman turret. This is a two-part instruction manual. And this is the rocket system itself, which I mentioned earlier, they've split the tubes in half. So that will be really difficult to get them looking nicely. Here's the upper hull. The lower hull and all the wheels and bogey assembly. Some decals there, and it does include a little sheet of photo-etch. The tracks themselves are made of that soft rubber, and they do come with the duckbills on the side. But I will be replacing those, so I won't need that. Alright, so what I think I'll do is I'll get started on the main tank first. Now I've covered this in a previous video, but the technique I've come up with for removing the seam line on the wheels, it's nice and fast and it gives you a nice uniform finish. I attach the wheel to a rotary drill piece and then just run it over some sandpaper. And you end up with a nice smooth round wheel. Now the track support roller bracket was made to mount to either side of the suspension mounting bracket. So there would have been four screw holes here. And on this side there would be the four bolts that hold this bracket in place. So I'll be adding that detail. Also getting rid of this seam here on the bracket. And the track skid was bolted down. It had two bolts in here and two up the front. So I'll be adding all that detail as well. So a couple of easy improvements to be made on the engine deck. The fuel cap splash had drainage holes drilled into the center. Also, the turret splash had a large drainage hole drilled about there. So I'll be adding those in. So for the tracks themselves, I'm going to be using these individual track links from AFV Club. I have the end connectors here with the guide horns on them, and the track links themselves, the T48 type, and I will be using these duckbill end connectors from a different set. And just to make it a bit easier to fit them all together, I've made this simple jig. Just line the track pieces up. I can glue the end connectors on with a bit of Tamiya Extra Thin. That way it gives me a lot of working time so I can mold the tracks over the sprockets and things. And once that's all in place, I can move it on down the jig and flip it over. And that lets me connect all of the duckbill connectors in. And that's one section of the track complete. Okay, so I have the first full length track done. All I need to do now is fit it to the tank. So that's both sides of the tracks complete. So I've decided to replace the plastic guard with some brass rod. Now the kit does come with some photo-etch light guards, and I will be using those in replace of the plastic ones. A good way to get a nice curve into a piece of photo etch is to bend it on a piece of foam. That way you can push in and then you can bring the sides up around it. I've just applied a little bit of putty at the base of the guards just to simulate it being welded on. With the Pioneer's tools, I'm going to be making my own tie downs. So what I need to do is to take these off the sprue and just remove any of the notches and things on them. I've left it so most of the tools can be removed, so I can get underneath and add the tie-down straps. Once they're in, then everything can be glued into place. So I just need to install a few of these handles onto the tank, and then I will be able to thread through the leather straps, and then I can install all of the tools back onto the tank. So that's all the pioneer tools strapped in. Most of them are not glued in, they're just held down by the straps, which are workable, so if I needed to remove them I can. Now there were a couple of additions commonly used on the Calliope. One was this gas deflector that was mounted onto the engine doors here, and also the use of a large storage box at the back of the tank. I'll be adding both of those. Now I've drawn up some plans here on the bit of card, which I will use to make up the deflector and the bin. Thank you. These are some photo-etch hinges I had left over from another kit. They are workable and I will be using them on the storage bin lid. I'm just going to use some of this Tamiya Basic putty just to remove that rather large seam in the turret. So that putty has had a couple of days to dry now, and I can sand that smooth. I'm just adding a little bit of extra detail here. It's a locking mechanism which was built into the 50 cal mounting bracket. Just going to alter this hasp here. It overhangs quite a way and doesn't line up with the hatch ring. It fits over there much better now. I'm just going to put a new hasp on the lotus hatch and I'm going to move it over to the opposite side. As the majority of reference material I've seen has it depicted that way. Now the springs that come with the kit for the lotus hatch are okay, but they're lacking a lot of detail. So I'm going to be making my own. So these two little pieces here are where these springs will attach to the turret. And for the springs themselves, I'm just going to use a piece of electrical wire. And then I'm going to wrap it around this piece of brass rod. Just have the brass rod as thick as you want the spring. Once the spring is done and cut to size, I need to make a couple of small loops either end, going opposite directions from each other. The spring was attached to the hatch via a small hook. I'm going to be using these spare hooks I have here. Just a couple of details I want to add to the commander's vein sight before I add it to the tank. Now with the main bulk of the tank done, this is where I'll conclude part one. And in part two, I'll be constructing the T-34 rocket system, mainly from scratch. So please subscribe and put your notifications on so you don't miss part two. I hope you've enjoyed watching so far. And until next time, thanks very much for watching.